My name is Mr. Sandesh Pare. I am currently working as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today I am going to focus on the topic which is called as the mobile commerce. In short, it is called as the m-commerce also. And nowadays we came to know that this is very trending thing. Okay, the lot of applications came into the commercial field, and especially on the mobile version. So it is very important to keep learning on these things. So what you'll be the student get after this session, they access the wireless technologies, okay, and their impact on the businesses, and they will understood the difference between location identification technologies and location based services, and they can construct the infrastructure and services which is required for wireless and m-commerce, and explain the advances being made in the mobile payment technologies. Okay, so now we are going to start the session by the looking the overview of the mobile commerce. M-commerce is any e-commerce which is done in a wireless environment, especially via the internet. Okay, it can be done via the internet, private communication lines, smart cards, etc. Okay, it creates the opportunity to deliver the new services to the existing customers and to attract the new one. The drivers which are used to implement the mobile commerce is the widespread availability of the devices, okay, and no need for PC, handset culture, vendors data pushing, okay, declining prices because as there is a competition, and improvement of the bandwidths by the telecommunication companies, and exploration of the EC in general. So these are the various terms which are focusing the mobile commerce into the picture nowadays. So we are going to see this diagram. Mobile interfaces are there, lot of interfaces, various devices, okay, here are there. And next, the classification of the m-commerce services. Basically, they can classify it into the different category, but we are going to focus on the main six categories. That is a financial category. Here we can say that the secure financial or the banking services which are provided to the user, which comes under this financial category. Okay, and second one is the entertainment category. Okay, mobile gambling, the various games, and movie ticketing, okay, all these things came under the entertainment category. Okay, and third category is the shopping. Okay, the purchasing of the goods on the various retailer shop or the big bazaar, and all the D-Mart like that. Okay, so you have to shop them through the m-commerce. And next one is the information category. Okay, whatever the information which is spread through the across the world, you can get access, okay, by using the m-commerce. Okay, just like paying the payment of the book, and you will get the soft copy of that book likewise. Okay, so you will get the information by the m-commerce also. Okay, and yes, the next phase is the payment category. In that you made payment to the particular person, retailer, and anything, anybody, okay, all over the world, so using the m-commerce. And next one is the advertising, and yes, intelligent advertising is one of the category of the m-commerce. So characteristics of the m-commerce, and just a second. So yes, this is the characteristics of the m-commerce, that is mobility and reachability. Okay, so value added attributes are there. Every characteristics, that is mobility and reachability, is containing Okay, that is the value added attributes like product and service localization, product personalization, ubiquity and ones, and instant connectivity and convenience. Okay, so these are the characteristics of the m-commerce. Mainly these are mobility and reachability, and value added attributes are like that. Okay, actually m-commerce is came into the picture by the one problem statement. Okay, what happens in that in San Francisco? Okay, the bus are going to travel from the one stop to the another one. Okay, and sometimes during the very rush hours, okay, which keeping the 20 minute schedule, okay, so it becomes problematic. Okay, and the station will post the something schedule, but it get lapsed by the actual bus. Okay, so due to this scenario, okay, the passengers may get hampered. Okay, because they don't know how the situation is going through. Okay, because they don't know the bus is arrived and dispatched. Okay, otherwise it may be get arrived. They don't know what is the actual location of the bus is there. Okay, and because the situation is showing some time, and it is not like that, and all that, passengers will get hampered due to this situation. So because of overcoming this situation, okay, it is digital over time, and soon location based advertisement, okay, just like where the actual location of the bus is actually, so that based upon that they will reach to the station also, they can commit any work before that also. So likewise it becomes use for the users. Okay, otherwise we can say the passengers. Okay, so the location based services are provided here. Okay, and these can be possible, okay, because of this GPS satellites, the device is set into the bus. Okay, and they transfer the data to the nearest tower or the base station, and based on that localization is done, wireless communication through the transfer of the data is done, and afterwards these servers, okay, and a lot of systems which are connected to this will get that particular data, and particular website is ready with all the data on that. Okay, and this whatever mobile devices which are used by the passengers, okay, they can visit that particular website, and by the particular ID of that bus, they can get the current location of the bus, and accordingly they will schedule, okay, their traveling time. So likewise it becomes very easy for the passengers to use this GPS system, and nowadays the railways and flights all are using this one, and for that passenger will get very comfortable with this issue. Okay, so they don't have to worry about what is missing the bus, maybe get diminished. Okay, it may discover the time for a cup of coffee before the bus arrives. Okay, they can schedule better, they can arrange extra buses when they need it. Okay, because they are not dependent on any one bus. Okay, and such a scenario improves the operations. Okay, so this technique is enabled, okay, via the transmission modes, that is the GPRS, where a step between the GSM and 3G cellular networks, and it supports widespread range of bandwidth and all. And WCDMA means code division multiple access. Okay, transmission technology for third generation, and rate is up to 2 Mbps, and it makes multimedia grows very rapidly. WAP protocol and iMode service, and yes, under the WAP protocol, it is open standard wireless application protocol, and WML and WAP gateway proxy, it needs action and payment according to time used. Okay, the first packet based service is the iMode, always on the mobile internet service, and various services available, banking, games, and payment according to the packet received. So the technologies which are used for that are the J2AC, J2ME, XML, and IPv6. So one question for you, that how do you can define the m-commerce exactly? same commerce means a mobile commerce in a simple words, buying and selling of the goods and services is called marketing. The other way, buying and selling of the goods and services through the wireless device, such as cellular phone, is called as the m-commerce. So these are various role player in the m-commerce. Okay, user, network operator, financial institute, and content provider. Okay, so as you can see in the diagram, there a user is paying the money to the content provider, and the books or the music is paid to the user by the content manager or the merchant. But the network operator and the financial institute are the connectivity between those two. Okay, and role of all the players here, the user is dealt with the security, privacy, ease of use and devices and all that. Financial institute provide authentication, integrity, non-reputation, fraud reduction and all that. Network provider is deal with the open standards, interoperability and roaming. And content merchant get paid, user adoption and low cost. These are the terms by the content provider. So MobiPay system, the how the process is actually done is shown step by step here. See, first of all, user chooses MoneyPay payment, then second is merchant sends unique MobiPay reference, and afterwards the third MobiPay system with the access, and later fourth one is the data validation, and next five pin request is the fifth step, and sixth is the pin response, and afterwards authentication, and later by the eighth you can actually transfer data to the wire, and yes, done the operation. So these are references I used to make this video. Thank you.